Boy, oh boy, that got interesting real fast today, didn't it, Hop? Hope you guys had a fantastic day out there. But it's time to get back to work tonight. You know me, we're only as good as our next trade, right? Time to get back to work. It's Tuesday evening. It's July 27th, 2021. My name is Joseph, and as always, welcome back to your nightly newsletter. Now, if you're watching for the first time tonight, it's great to have you with me because my job tonight, very important job tonight, help us find the best trade setups for tomorrow. Not just any Wednesday, FOMC hump day trading session. I got a great video in store for you guys tonight. Charts are all ready in the background. S&P's ready. NASDAQ's ready. Gold is ready. Glad to see you are ready right along with us. Got a lot of great trades setting up on the radar for tomorrow. Big moves down on the E-minis and the NASDAQ. Big potential range rotation on the gold. I'd love to get short. Would love to short this bounce on the S&P. Would love to short this bounce on the NASDAQ. Would love to trade short to finish off the rotation on the gold. But yeah, tomorrow's an FOMC day though. Is there any chance this could be just a big dump before they pump it back up? You know there's a possibility for that. So got a lot to cover in tonight's video. By the end of this lesson tonight, you'll know my favorite trades for tomorrow. You'll also know some stuff to avoid, right? So you stay out of trouble tomorrow, whether you're trading on your own or you're trading with us tomorrow morning in our trade room. Before we jump into the video tonight, though, as always, make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel. I publish this video every evening, my best trade ideas for the following day. I don't want you to miss tomorrow night's video, so make sure you subscribe. Hit that little bell icon every time you do. That way you always get notified every time we publish something new. And if you have any questions, drop those questions for me, all right? Don't be bashful. Love to answer all your questions. And if you guys enjoy this video as much as I enjoy making it every evening, do me a favor. Hit that like button, that thumbs up button for us on this video tonight. But as you can see, I'm a bit late on the time here tonight. Let's get this video going. We're going into Wednesday. Fed Day is tomorrow. Fed Day has a very specific personality to it, and we're going to dive into that here tonight on this video. S&P's down, NASDAQ's down. Of course, gold is potentially down right for tomorrow. Like I said, I'd love to short these bounces right now, big bounces right now. Big down day, would love to short these bounces. And of course, you know, again, since tomorrow's an FOMC announcement day, right, you have to be ready for a possible reversal. So I'll definitely have some reversal trades on my radar. I could also see some great trades for some bounce reversals right off of those lows. So there's lots of sell side trades. There's lots of buy side trades on the E-mini NASDAQ, S&P and NASDAQ for tomorrow. And again, on the gold here, we've got a bear market range here. Would love to trade that rotation. Got some great targets waiting down there, 1790, 1784, and beyond. And again, with tomorrow being an FOMC announcement, you'd be foolish not to be at least prepared, right, for a rip going higher here on the yellow metal. So we're going to break this all down tonight. Before we jump into these charts, though, I just want to make sure to remind you what's on the schedule for tomorrow. Tomorrow, of course, is Wednesday. Now, I talked about this a lot last night, right? We're going to the end of the month. The end of the month is always expected to be an increased in volatility, right? Why? Because of scarcity. There's not much time left in the month for traders to pad their numbers, right? So that scarcity, that creates a lot of anxiety in the markets, and you can feel it, right? There is that jumpiness and that personality, right, as we go into the end of the month. Tomorrow, as you mentioned in last night's newsletter, is FOMC day. What that means for us is that we really have a hard time trading the afternoon session. You got to make your money tomorrow, early in the day tomorrow. Now, you're more than welcome to gamble around the FOMC, but one thing I always try to remind you guys is to save your bullets, because the mess that happens during the FOMC announcement tomorrow afternoon, by the time the dust settles, we get the benefit of reaction Thursday. Don't go blowing your account gambling on Wednesday afternoon, because anytime we have a big news day, let's say on Wednesday, the following day is usually where the easy money is, right? So make sure you save your bullets. The most important thing about tomorrow, though, is, again, we're not going to have we're not going to have the afternoon session. So again, that creates more scarcity, right? So that lack of availability really puts all of our pressure on the morning session, really up until about 11 o'clock 11:30 tomorrow morning. I also want to remind you, too, we are watching gold roll over right now. It's a little bit tough to tell when gold's going to roll over. It's not as consistent as the E-minis or the oil markets. Right now, we are watching, again, that 821. We're on 821 right now on the gold right now. We will make the jump to that 1221 contract. They're telling me it's tomorrow, but who knows? It could be tomorrow. Could be Thursday. At some point here, probably next 2 days here, we are going to see that 1221 contract take over the volume on the gold. We're going to skip that 1021 contract. We'll go right to that 1221 contract. So be aware of that if you're a gold trader like we are in our trade room. I think those were the big stuff, right? FOMC tomorrow. End of month volatility, rollover on gold. We made it through Tech Tuesday, right? Should have been called Bloodbath Tuesday for the tech companies there. Bottom line, though, is scarcity, volatility. And again, for tomorrow, we want to make our money early in the day tomorrow because, again, we've got the FOMC announcement at 2 o'clock Eastern time. As I mentioned earlier, early in, early out. Don't. Well, I mean, you can do whatever you want, right? But my best advice to you and my clients out there who are tuning in right now is stay out of the waters when things get choppy around FOMC. The hard part about the FOMC is that the spread gets so wide, the volatility, the liquidity dries up, and you can really, you can make a lot of money in a short period of time, but that knife cuts both ways. And all it takes is a couple big chunks out of your account. Remember, you lose 50% of your account, you're going to make 100% return on that money. So protect your capital, save those bullets for reaction Thursday. That's where the easy money is. And we'll talk about that tomorrow night, of course, right, in tomorrow night's video. Tomorrow morning, we don't have a lot of news on the radar. We got the international trade number at 8:30. We got a little bit, right, a little bit of stuff around 10 o'clock, but not a lot tomorrow morning. So we're kind of wide open tomorrow morning. Whenever there's no major news for us to work with in the morning session, usually the best trades will be sometime between 9:45 and 11 o'clock, right? You know, there's no catalyst tomorrow. We don't really get some big news until we go into Thursday, obviously, except for the FOMC tomorrow. We don't get any more big news until the GDP and jobs, right, and the income on Friday. So, 9:30 open, 9:30 NYC open, 9:45 to 11 o'clock tomorrow. I would imagine that's where you're probably going to get the best setups, right? Once the opening bell rings, the market, of course, opens up. Now, tomorrow morning, don't forget, right? Early in, early out. You don't want to be late to the trade room tomorrow morning. I'll put a link here in the description of this YouTube video. I would definitely grab that link, get registered. Don't be late for tomorrow's trade room because tomorrow is one of those days you want to get in early, make your money early, and get out of there early. So keep your lunch plans tomorrow because it'll be an early, relatively early lunch tomorrow morning in our trade room. And then, of course, the FOMC announcement is tomorrow afternoon. Be careful around the FOMC announcement. It's very, very whippy, very illiquid. It can be very dangerous environment. Save those bullets for reaction Thursday. Let's get over to the charts now. S&P's ready. NASDAQ's ready. Gold is ready. Everything's bearish, right? Everything's bearish. Everything is bearish right now. The most important thing, though, is big down days, big moves today, right? Big moves today on the S&P and the NASDAQ. Remember, anytime we see a big move today, oftentimes the following day is a narrow range. So kind of keep that in mind for tomorrow, especially with tomorrow being an FOMC day. We may see some range bound markets. Whenever you see big moves on one day, the following day is oftentimes a range. And also goes for gold too. Anytime we see a range on one day, we oftentimes see a breakout, right, the following day. So that works the opposite way as well. All right, let's grab the S&P and let's get this party going here. And don't forget, I'm going to add chapters at the bottom of this video. So I know you're going to watch this whole thing from start to finish, but if you want to go back after the fact and grab those chapters at the bottom, you can pick and choose where you kind of go back if you want to use it as a reference point here throughout the day tomorrow. All right, what's the key takeaway on the S&P right now? The key takeaway is we have a very strong bear move down. Anytime we see a very strong move in one direction, we know there's a big bullseye to retest that low. We also know, which is pretty interesting here, that the morning session pretty much got trapped up in a range, right? We spent the morning this morning buying low, selling high, trading that range. What is very interesting, because ranges, of course, act like magnets, is to see the market make that big move down and pull all the way back to the underbelly of that range. A classic range breakout pullback scenario. We see these quite a bit. Where you see a, you know, a bear market goes sideways, it obviously breaks out, but then nobody wants to sell low down here, right? So they, what do? They wait to sell the pop, right? And they want to drop it back down, right, to retest the low. So, you know, the bears have all of, well, I shouldn't say all of the momentum. The bulls do have a relatively strong pop off that low, which definitely tells me to respect the momentum of the short-term buyers. But make no mistake about it, there is a big bullseye right down at that low. At this point, it really, all we do now is kind of wait for some more information. You know, probably the best possible trade for tomorrow would be to get these buyers to be roped in, trying once, trying twice, draw a trend line off that low, trend line off that high, right, and sell short off that trend line. These can often get pretty good because sometimes they'll really drop and you can find a new channel off of that new push lower, right? That would probably be the best possible scenario for sellers here as we go into the overnight, into tomorrow's trading session. Again, big, strong bear move down. No doubt about direction right now. But again, we have a very, you know, a significant pop off that low. It makes sense where they pop back to the base of that range from earlier on in the day. Now, those buyers, they want to go back up, right? They want to go back to those all-time highs. Let them try once. Let them try twice. Their stops are sitting right below those lows, right? And we're looking to short into those stop losses with what I call a two-try failure pattern. Now, once we get those buyers stuck and we short back into those stops now, now mark that low, mark that high, and this is the trade you really have to get into. This is the one, it's non-negotiable in my trade room. You know, sometimes you might miss that failure off the high. You know, it happens. Sometimes you miss it. Sometimes you're not quite sure about direction at that point. It's understandable. It's unless you have experience with it, it's easy to miss. The market drops back down. That's the one right there that you've got to get into. Now remember, right, we're not going to take that pullback off a 7,000 tick chart, right? This is a 7,000 tick chart you can see listed up there in the upper right-hand corner. What I'm going to do is I'm going to drill down to a faster time frame, and the two best price action entry setups are going to be traps, failures, and then failures oftentimes lead into pullback moves. Now, I'm not going to go into all the price action setups we use in our trade room, but I do cover all the price action setups, how to find levels of support and resistance, the charts to use, the indicators to use, with our shortcut class, right? I'll put a little link up there for you in the upper right-hand corner. Our quick start class will bring you right up to speed with the charts, the indicators, the time frames, how to find levels of support and resistance that work best, and of course, how to time the entries with price action. We don't rely on indicators for entries because indicators are too late, right? They're too lagging. So if you want to learn all the details of the entry setups and a whole lot more, definitely check out that quick start class in the upper right-hand corner. Now, we may not get that beautiful 1-2, right? And then back down again. Sometimes what happens is the market slips, right? And goes one like that. If that happens, just stay patient, wait for that trap. Just don't be too aggressive, right? On that short down there, right? So again, it pops back up. We pull back. The buyers try once, buyers try twice. You want that trap, right? You definitely want that trap, right? As we go lower. And honestly, if things really start to accelerate as we go lower, right? If we were to really dump and run lower here, you can start watching for the two-try trap, which basically means a strong move down, a shallow pullback, a lower low in price, right? And a trap high, right? Off of that high, right? So there's plenty of ways to sell this thing, right? As it goes lower. And of course, if it really starts, let's say, for example, it moves lower, the bears come over, they hold that pullback and jump, right, off the moving average, right? You can see right here, right? We don't get that jump, right? If they would go 1-2 go, right, off of that low like that, that's when, again, you mark up that low, You mark up that high, find that hidden channel. And this is one of those times where I remind you, if you have that 1-2-3 move off the moving average, I don't care if I'm right into that low. If you have enough momentum and a good setup, again, I'm not going to go over all the price action setups in this video, but I covered those right in the quick start class. I mentioned linked up in the upper right-hand corner, right? But if you have enough momentum and you get a good setup off the top of that channel, you know, maybe not a full-size position, but you've got to take that trade. That's a good trade. Take it, right? Where do the bears want to go? The bears, of course, want to get back to retest the low, but where's their big objective? Their big objective is probably down to that 43.50 area, which is a big, it isn't a huge range, but it's pretty much the next big milestone here for those bears. So now we have a good idea, right, how to sell this thing, right, as it goes lower here. And honestly, if the market, you know, if the market popped up a little bit higher here, I would still be open, right, to those one try, two try, right, short into those, right, two try failures, mark up that low, mark up that high, right, that same sequence that we love so much in our trade room, right? Two try failure into that first channel pullback. And again, it's not really a pullback, right? It's a trap setup. It's a failure setup right off of that high. I would still be open-minded to that, even if we saw another little push higher here, which kind of taps the underbelly of that range, okay? That's how I would sell that market. How do we buy this market right now? Can I buy this? There are really two ways to buy this market right now. One way would be we go back to retest the low. The bears come in now, they try once, they try twice, right? Because you're not going to buy. I don't care how much support we have right here, right? If we're this bearish, I'm not going to buy into that freight train. But I will wait for exhaustion. And once we see bears try twice, we know all the bears are roped in. Their stops are sitting right above that high. And remember, this could easily turn into a range tomorrow, right? There's no reason why this couldn't be a range tomorrow because, again, big day today, right? Narrow range or range tomorrow. If we can get down, take out those lows. Remember, there's a big bullseye right at that low right now. If we can take out those lows right now, if I can get the bears to commit a couple times down here, right? Then, of course, their stops are sitting ducks up top there now. Couple ways I can trade this. One of my favorite ways to do it is off of the trend line, or I can simply buy into those stop losses, right? You're buying off the trend line, you're buying a stop loss. Again, we call these two-try failure patterns. In this case, it'd be a two-try reversal. And then, of course, as always, don't forget, you can grab that new channel, right? Mark up that new high, mark up that new low. I can buy that first pullback. That's kind of one of the most reliable ways to do it, right? And again, remember, we're not going to buy the pullback on that. We're going to drill down to a faster time frame. We'll find those bear traps. We'll find those seller failures off the moving average, right? We talk about in the quick start class. Another thing to kind of keep in mind would be, let's say it goes something like this, where it really rips, right? Let's say it really rips higher here now. You know, at that point now, you don't get the pullback, right? The pullback doesn't happen. It rips higher. At that point now, you can grab that trap with that two-try trap. Remember, if you have enough momentum, right? If you have enough momentum, strong move up, shallow pullback, higher high, that trap will work as well, right? So two-try failure into a two-try trap, right? Going higher here, right? The magic number there, number two, right? And we talk about the two-try rule and why the number two is so important in that quick start class, right? We'll go over all the basics there. All right, that's an easy way to buy it. Does take some patience. Other way to buy it here would be a reversal, right? Let's say, for example, we see the buyers coming in. I could easily see buyers coming in, grabbing that trap and running. Right? Grabbing that trap and running here. If they run going higher here, couple different ways you can do it. What I'll be looking for, I think probably the best way to buy that to the trap and go would be to grab a strong move up, shallow pullback, higher high in price, grab those traps, and keep an eye on a channel. Right, keep an eye on a small channel there, right, to buy off of that low. It may also be a jump up, right? Buyers come in, they hold that pullback, they jump off the moving average. That's called a 1-2-3 reversal pattern. Very, very simple pattern right now. The key is we have to get the buyers to show us they want this. Right now, all we know is this is a great place to get short. But if the buyers can hold this and go, right, if they can really get a good jump jump off that moving average. Now those all-time highs are easily seen on our radar. The range above us is the magnet. You can easily mark up that high, mark up that low, drill down to a faster time frame, right? Find your bear trap, find your failure setup, failure into pullback, pullback into strength. I cover all those price action setups right in that quick start class linked up in the upper right-hand corner. So either we jump off of this low, right? Jump off that pullback into a trap setup, right? Or we're looking for that deeper channel, right? That bigger channel, right? To buy off that channel. Either one of those will work, right? As we go higher. Remember, as we go higher, if you have enough momentum going higher, those traps, those channel pullbacks, they're definitely worth, right, consideration. Where would those buyers want to go, by the way? They definitely want to go back up to retest those all-time highs. Again, like I said earlier, tomorrow's an FOMC day. This could be one big pump dump and pump, right? The opposite, right? It could be dump it right down and rip it right back up tomorrow, right, as FOMC comes out. Just remember, early in, early out. The one thing we haven't talked about here is a range, right? The one thing we haven't talked about is a range here. This 84.5, right? What is 84.5? 84.5 is a prior, right? It's basically a prior high, right? Which if you look at it on the chart, it makes sense this market kind of sits here right now, right? It is a pretty sticky area here on this chart. So if we were to happen to go sideways, right, around this area, how would I trade that? Right? How would I trade that if it went sideways here? What you want to do is find levels of support below the range, find levels of resistance above the range, and buy low and sell high. So if we start, right, if we start going sideways here overnight, right, we're chopping around, we're going to find levels of resistance above, we're going to wait for price to break out, we're going to let those buyers, right, those breakout buyers try to get long, and we're going to sell right back into their stop losses. Remember, ranges act like magnets. You know, same thing too, right? If we go sideways tomorrow, what I'll do is I'll find probably that level right there, right? Find a prior support level there. What I always do is once I know the size of the range, then I use those range expansions, right? So once we know the size of the range, that will tell us where our range expansions are. Again, I talk about this stuff right in the quick start class. But once you know the size of the range, then you can find your support levels are usually equal to the size of that range. Wait for that breakdown. Wait for those bears to try and fail, right? And we'll go right back up into that range again. So ranges are pretty simple. Once you see the range, find levels of support and resistance, right, which are usually calculated based on the size of that trading range, and buy low, sell high, and focus on those failure patterns. We'll talk more, obviously, about the small details of this tomorrow morning, the trade room, but definitely keep an eye out for a range there for tomorrow. The money on the short side, though, the short side right now is who has control right now. So until those buyers can get either a reversal or get something changing here, we've got to focus on the sell side as we go. Let's keep going. I want some NASDAQ here for tomorrow. NASDAQ, of course, very similar to the S&P. NASDAQ probably had a stronger move down than the E-minis did today. NASDAQ has a really beautiful chart here. The most important thing to keep in mind is this very strong move down. There's a big bullseye right on that low, right? Right on that low. I love how, and you can see the measured move was completed there, right, as well. I love how they took out, right, those lows right up around this high. And you can kind of see, right, you draw that channel off the lows, you bring it right up around that high. They're right up above some couple prior swings there. It doesn't get much better than that spot right there. The only problem we have on this, it's a very wide channel. It's a really wide channel. You know, when I have a really steep channel, right, really steep channel, you know, steep channels, you can grab traps all day long on steep channels, right? You can get real aggressive when the channel's steep and tight like that, right? When you have a wide channel like this, what's the problem? Momentum. Right, by the time we pull back off that low, the buyers are going, oh shoot, we have this thing, right? We can do this, go back, right? The buyers, you know, whether or not they're gonna be successful or not, we have to assume these buyers are going to put up a fight, right? Whenever you see a wide channel. So a wide channel is great because a wide channel gives you a great risk reward, right? Don't get me wrong, But there's always a price to pay for risk-reward, right? There's always a cost to having a good risk-reward ratio, right? And usually that cost is momentum. So how do we absorb momentum? We talked about this, right, on the S&P, right? With all of that big bounce off of that low, kind of the ideal entry here would be buyers once, buyers twice. Their stops are sitting right below that low. I can sell into those stop losses. What I love to get, though, is get a channel drawn off that low, a channel off that high, right, and short off of right off of that high, or even better, between you, me, and YouTube, right, off that trap, right? That would be, boy, oh boy, that would be a primo short here as we go, right? And remember, don't forget, oftentimes these things will collapse, and you can grab that new channel coming off that low, off that high. And again, if you have enough momentum, right, collapsing down to that low, that short is still a very must-take trade, right? So a two-try failure, right, into a 1-2-3 reversal, right, hidden channel pullback. And again, we're not going to trade off of this 5,000 tick chart, right? This is a bird's eye view of the market. Tomorrow morning, we'll drill down to a much faster time frame and we'll grab those price action setups, right? Those failures, those traps, those pullbacks, those strength moves. And again, I talk about all the price action setups, how we time the entries, the right time frames to use. I cover all those basics, right, in our quick start class. It's a great shortcut course to bring you guys up to speed if you're watching here for the first time today. That's definitely something on my radar here for tomorrow. And, you know, also too, that 15,000 area, you know, honestly, again, like just the S&P, right? If we did go a bit higher here, I would still be open-minded to that same sequence, right? That same 1-2 and then grab that pullback. I would still be open-minded there, even if it did kind of get up into that 15,000, buyers once, buyers twice, right, and back down. I wouldn't shy away from that either as well, because that will be a level of resistance up overhead. As the market goes lower, right, as the market goes lower, you'll notice one kind of big difference to the S&P and the NASDAQ. It does look like there's a range down here. And so in addition to the big low, we can also manage or mark up the pendulum swing, right? Like I mentioned earlier, once you know the size of the range, that really helps you calculate a lot of other people, you know, a piece of information here. So once we get the move up, we can calculate now that rotation, and that puts a big bullseye down on that 14,716. This could easily, right, pop up, buyers once, buyers twice, get that, again, that two-try failure, and then dump back down. We grab that, right, grab that channel, short off that channel, and leave that final target all the way down, right, at that 14,716 and a quarter, right? So there's plenty of options, right, as we're going lower. If we don't get these buyers to commit, right? They've already tried once. We're waiting for a second time right now. If the buyers, for example, if they just run lower, right? If this thing starts to sprint going lower, don't hesitate to grab that two-try trap setup. Traps will be on our radar if the market simply starts to sprint, right, and run lower. And if you don't know what I mean by sprint, right? When it starts to separate, right? Like back here. Look at the moving average, right? See how they're not pulling back, right? They're not pulling back to this moving average. Once you start seeing it run away from the moving average, that's exactly when you start looking for these trap setups, right? Because you know there's something going on, there's so much momentum out there, any trap is going to be sold, right? It's a really good example. You know, if we start seeing something like that as the market starts to move lower, right, starts to separate away from the moving average, the minute that starts to happen, you know that trap is money, baby, right? That's a money trap. Now, you know, again, it's a little bit scary to sell into the low a day, but if it really starts to push, though, there's a very good chance, right, that we're going to keep another leg going lower, and you get a pretty good idea now of where that target may be, right, down around that pendulum swing. If things really start to turn into a bloodbath tomorrow, we'll be keeping an eye on the 14,668, the runaway double down target, though, around 14,580 here for tomorrow. I would be surprised if we see another another big move tomorrow, just because it's a Fed day. And oftentimes, right, again, the big day today means a small range here for tomorrow. So now, again, we get a pretty good idea here, right, for how to sell this market right now. How do we buy it? The buy side here is going to be wait and see. We really have to get down, take out those lows, right? I can trade the bounce reversal, right? So big move down, they retest the low, they basically get what they wanted. Now let those bears try a couple times. Let them try once, let them try twice. Their stops are sitting right above that high now. I can place my buy right above those highs and buy as we go. My favorite way to do it is to draw that trend line and buy off that trend line. That way you're buying nice and low on that, right? And then again, don't forget, once you get the buy going higher, right, oftentimes that market will pop up and then pull back relatively quickly. You can grab that classic combination, right, that failure setup into that first pullback. And again, we're going to drill down to a faster time frame. Okay, we're not going to buy the pullback blindly of a 5,000 tick chart. We'll drill down to a faster time frame, find our price action setups, right, and jump in from there. So we're looking for that turn off of that low. And then it happens a lot, actually, if it does just run, right? If it really runs, right? Doesn't pull back right away. If it really runs and runs higher here, again, the minute you start seeing this thing separate away from that moving average, all of that momentum, you know where they want to go. They want to go back up and take out those highs, right? Markets love to rotate back and forth like that. So the minute you start seeing that separation again away from that moving average, that's enough momentum. Traps, baby, right? Grab that trap. Any trap will be a buying opportunity. If we can get that failure, right, into that pop, that shallow pullback, that higher high, that's a beautiful setup. I'll look for those every day of the week. Again, the key here is you're taking out the low, right? You wouldn't do it right now, right? But you wait for them to take the low out. Once they take the low out, once the sellers get what they want, then they go, okay, right? You're not going lower. Okay, let's give you once, twice, right? Buy into those stops, grab that, right? Grab that new channel and rip it, right? Right back up to retest the high. Because again, this could end up being one big range tomorrow. It really could be. So again, plenty of price action setups on our radar for tomorrow. We'll obviously fill in more of the blanks tomorrow morning in the trade room. As we go higher, again, we really have to get some good momentum. Now, that momentum could come in the form of a 1-2 really strong move. And if that happens, it's pretty easy. Mark up the high, mark up that low, drill down to your faster time frame. And usually what happens is, if you were to zoom in on that area, usually what happens is we'll get below the moving average, right? We'll get that. We'll get those bears trying to sell short, failure, pullback, strength combination, failure, pullback, strength combination. If you were to kind of zoom in, right? If you were to zoom in on that area right there, that's kind of what you're looking for. I talk about that stuff, right, in the Quick Start class. But that is obviously what you're looking for, right, as the market goes higher. We may not get that. You know, we may just get a very strong run higher here. All they get is a shallow pullback, a higher high. If we see enough, right, again, enough strength, that shallow pullback, that higher high, you know, everybody wants that trap entry before we go back up right into that range and really potentially back up to get those all-time highs up there at that 15,100, 15,134 area as we go. So again, just gotta be patient. Either be patient to buy off the low with that exhaustion pattern, or be patient for proof of that reversal, right? That 1-2-3 reversal, and then patient to wait for that pullback or that trap, right? Or that run, shallow pullback, higher high, right, in that trap. Either one of those will work really well, right, off of that high. And they're very basic. You know, they're not very complex patterns, and that's the beauty of the whole thing. They don't need to be complicated. I mean, we use the same boring old patterns over and over again in our trade room, and they work great because they rope in that combination of market psychology, right? Market psychology and trapping in the opposite side of the market. When you get the opposite side of the market backed into a corner, they have no choice but to exit for a loss. And usually that means you get your profit targets hit pretty darn quickly. All right, guys. So again, got a lot of potential for the NASDAQ going lower. Let's see what these buyers do with this stuff here overnight. Let's wrap it up tonight on the gold. Moving over on gold here right now. Gold has shown us now we have a new trading range on our hands. We've had that bigger range, of course, the last couple days here. We do see proof now of a larger range. Now, be careful here. If there's one market tomorrow that might not be that easy, it's going to be the gold market. You've got rollover on our radar. Anytime we have the Fed announcement, right? You know, what is the Fed talking about? They're talking about raising rates. They're talking about stimulus. They're talking about things that affect the U.S. dollar, the monetary policy. If there's one market tomorrow that might give us a bit of a headache, this is definitely it. This is definitely it. And you can definitely tell there's a range involved. Ranges act like magnets, right? So whenever you see a range like this, what do? You buy low at support, right? You sell high at resistance. You focus on failures and you trade the rotation. Right? You trade the rotation. So right now, the key takeaway is it's a bear market going lower into a trading range. What do you do with a bear market into a range? You find levels of resistance above the range, right? Like prior swings, like hidden channels. Love that channel. That's a beautiful channel, right? They roll lower. Same basic technique we saw on the NASDAQ where you draw the channel backwards, right? Off of those lows, pop it up at the highs. Right, I talk a lot about these techniques, by the way, right, in our quick start class in the upper right-hand corner there, linked up the upper right-hand corner. So again, it makes perfect sense now that you see a lot of bears coming in and shorten that sucker, right, as we go. And what I love about this example is you'll notice as we pull back, right, buyers once, buyers twice, see that channel? See that channel right there? That's exactly the pattern we're looking for on the NASDAQ, on the S&P, and it should come to no surprise that sellers put their back into that one, right? They definitely gave that one the old college try. So we definitely see that short going lower. What is interesting about that, though, is you'll notice they got kind of hung up, right, at those lows. And this definitely does remind us that we have a range going on here right now, and we're, you know, towards the low of that trading range. So bears definitely have it, right? Bears definitely have it. There certainly is going to be a little bit of support level here, right? You know, probably going to be a bit of a triangle on this. It's not too confirmed just yet, but it's something I'm watching as we go into tomorrow. You know, In these environments, you want to buy low, sell high. How would we trade this? How do we trade this? Well, one way to do it is, if the market was to go higher here, okay, we're still up at levels of resistance. The range is still in play down here. But what's the problem? We've got failed rotation, right? We should be rotating all the way down, right? So if the market does go higher here, it's not a reversal, because what confirms reversals? Reversals have to hold pullbacks and go, right? Just like on the S&P and the NASDAQ, right? You know, we are right there right now on the S&P and the NASDAQ. If those buyers can't hold this and go, it's gonna get crushed back down again, right? That's why we're gonna short that S&P and NASDAQ once those buyers try a few times. Now, if we go higher here, right? If we go higher here, are the buyers in control? No, they're not in control yet, but we had a lot of evidence that the buyers do have a lot more than we thought they did, right? Gotta respect that lack of rotation, right? There's gonna be something going on there. So how do we absorb that? We let them try twice, right? We go right back here, right? Let them try once. Let them try twice. All those stops are right below that low, right? And then, of course, sell back into that range. If this thing really starts to push, now what you do is you mark up that low, you mark up that high, right? And you grab that first short, right, off the high. You trade the rotation, right? We're selling a two-try failure, and I know I've talked a lot about those today so far, but hey, that just happens to be what's the best appropriate solution to this scenario right now. Deep pullbacks on the S&P and NASDAQ is why you want that. On this one, the failed rotation is why you need to let those buyers try twice, right? Trend lines coming in. So we definitely want to let those bulls, right, try a few times. Again, if we get really lucky here, we'll grab that trend line coming off, right? Short off that trend line, shorten those stop losses, short that first pullback, right? Now, sometimes you don't get it, right? Sometimes it'll crash lower, and you just simply don't get that short, right? So you want to take the failure, and if you get that continuation, good. If you don't, then, you know, hey, wait for the next one, right? Keep waiting till you get the right entry set up, right? And we'll talk more about that tomorrow morning, obviously, right, in our trade room. Big target, of course, is that pendulum swing, right, down at that 1789 area. Now, as we go higher, that definitely opens the door wide open for these buyers, right? Because if we fail rotation and if we get this thing to pop higher here now, could we start to look for a 1-2-3 reversal, 1-2-3 breakout? Absolutely, right? So if we get enough, it'd be a little more than that, right? If we see this thing really punch going higher here now, right? Mark up that high, mark up that low, right? Get underneath the moving average. That's why I draw my channels backwards. Get underneath the moving average. Get those bears to try to sell short off the moving average. That gives you exactly where those entries need to be. Failure, right? Pullback combination, strength moves, trap moves going higher. So many ways to trade this. So many ways to trade this after we get that 1-2-3 reversal, right? Failure, pullback, trap setup. Where would these buyers be trying to go? Where do they want to go here, right? We got a big, big range up overhead. That seems to be pretty, you know, pretty sensational for tomorrow, right? That seems to be a little bit out of reach for tomorrow, but did I mention it's tomorrow's FOMC day? So don't count anything out, right, on the yellow metal. Now, again, it might be pretty choppy tomorrow morning, though. We may not get that big move until tomorrow afternoon. So remember, save those bullets, right, for reaction Thursday. So we definitely have that on our radar right now, right, as we go higher here. As we go lower, again, I think it's relatively easy pickings. If we make a strong run down, you know where these bears want to get to. In fact, there's even a big trend line down here. Big, big trend line. If this thing really starts to bottom out here, that trend line low and that big range magnet down there, 1783, 1780, huge, huge targets, right, as we go. What you'd want to do on this, though, is either wait for a two-try trap, right? So strong move down, right? Shallow pullback, lower low in price. Everybody's waiting to sell above that high, right? Everybody wants that trap, right? Now remember, this could happen here. It could happen here. If you have enough momentum, take the darn trade, right? No excuses. Take that trade. If you want to go half size or quarter size position, one contract, but your job is to take that trade short when you have that much momentum. We may not get that big strength, right? Maybe we take a move lower, the bears pull back, nothing too spectacular, and then blammo, right? We get that big jump off the moving average, right? Didn't get it there. Maybe tomorrow's a day, right? Maybe tomorrow's a day we break those lows here. I don't know, but if we do see it, mark up that low, mark up that high, drill down to a faster time frame, right? Don't be foolish. We're not trading a 1500 tick chart. Not as day traders we aren't, right? Not as short-term traders. I'm going to drill down to a much faster time frame, find those bull traps, right? Find those buyer failures, those pullbacks, those strength moves, those trap entries, right? As we rotate off the high of that channel. Again, I go into all the details of the price action setups we use. I cover that stuff in that quick start class, right? That is a trade you don't want to miss. The two-try trap, right, is a trade that you don't want to miss. And again, as you can see, right, I use the same recipe over and over and over again. That's why our trade room is so effective, because it builds that repetition over and over and over again. We use a very simple set of rules. We follow those stuff together every day, 8 o'clock Eastern time in our trade room. I think the only problem tomorrow would be if we get stuck inside the range here. Oh, one more thing too. Could we buy that low? Right? If I took out that low, right, could I buy this back up again? You definitely can. It's a range, right? But what's the problem? Momentum, right? Momentum. So what do? You give the bears the respect that they deserve, right? You let them try a few times and you pop them, right? You hit them right where it hurts. Okay? These are easy, easy trades. Just gotta wait for it. That's all. That's the hardest part. The hardest part is just not buying off that low, because you know what's going to happen, right? Eventually, they're going to push on through. And while you're trying to pick that bottom, you're missing that next follow-up trade, right, to short that high. That's always how it goes, right? When you're trying to pick tops and bottoms, you're missing the follow-up trades, right? It's that opportunity cost. When you're getting too aggressive, trying to be gambling, right, trying to predict, you're oftentimes missing the good stuff hidden in the price action. All right, guys, you definitely can buy that low with the right setup, those two try failures. Remember, if we sit sideways here and go sideways, right, save your bullets, find those levels of resistance, get up, failure, back down, right? We're still going to have those bears bias. Even if it goes sideways here, right? Even if it goes sideways here and then punches, I can still use 1, 2, 3 breakout. Mark that, right? Mark that channel and short off the top of that channel. No, I'm not going to sell the first one, but I will definitely sell the first pullback once we find that channel or it busts lower, shallow pullback, lower low, right? In that two try trap from there. Those are two, both, those are very reliable, even if we get the range. Right, even if the range happens here, because again, we still have that big rotation we're looking for as we go. All right, guys, boy, great video tonight. Hope you guys had a fantastic day out there. Tomorrow is a big day. Like I mentioned earlier, don't spend those bullets. Don't, you know, keep a couple in the chamber for Thursday, because Thursday is oftentimes the big money day, right? After an FOMC day on Wednesday. Tomorrow morning, 8 o'clock Eastern time, I'm gonna see you there with me, right? Every morning, Monday through Friday, we trade this stuff together. All of the membership links you guys need are below this video tonight on the blog, or I'll put a link in the description of this YouTube video. If you have any questions, you can always call the office. I'm always here to help out every step of the process, even if it's just to figure out the best computers, the charts, the software, you know, to get the ball rolling in the right direction. Don't be afraid to email us. Drop some questions in the comment section below. We got live chat on the left, live chat on the right. Would love to help if you guys need any help along the way. But that's it for tonight. Get out of here. Have a great rest of your evening. Rest up. Busy, busy day tomorrow. Don't hit that snooze button tomorrow, right? Early in, early out. I'll see you guys tomorrow morning at the opening bell. If not, you better come back and see me tomorrow night. We're getting ready for, right, for Money Making Thursday, right, in tomorrow night's video newsletter. All kidding aside, have a great rest of your evening out there, guys. Thanks for tuning in. My name is Joseph. Be well out there. Be nice to each other, all right? And be here next time. Adios, amigos. Bye-bye for now.